We thank Almighty Allah for sparing our lives. We thank Almighty Allah for giving us life. We thank Almighty Allah for giving us what we need. Though the problem of human being is what we want, but the human being can never get the want. We only get the need. Either you like it or not, Allah will give you your need. But Allah can never give you your wants. Never. If Allah gives us the wants, there are some things that will not be relevant again. Myself, I need 10 cars. If Allah gives me 10 cars, where do I want to park it? My neighbor needs 10 cars. I need mansions. My neighbor needs mansions. Who wants to be the gate man? Who wants to be the house help? Allah cannot give you your wants. So that's why we thank Him for giving us our need. And He will continue giving you your need. He will continue giving you your need until the day we now ask you, how did you use it? ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَ إِذِنَ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ Allah will now ask, how did you spend what I know that you need and I give it to you? He knows that we need eyes. Allah give us eyes. He knows that we need legs. He give us legs. As the entrance, you see some people there without eyes. Have we ever asked Allah or ourselves, why did you give me eyes and you don't give this person? كُلُّكُمْ رَاعِي وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْئُولُ عَنْ رَاعِيَتِهِ All of you are shepherd. And Allah shall ask you, how did you use what I keep under you? So we should always thank Allah. Last week, praying that we were still alive together. Last week, we are still alive together as a Muslim. On Sunday, the wife called Ifedan from the bed, 4 a.m. They rushed him to the hospital. Day before yesterday, we received the news he has passed on. So why me have not died and you have not died? It has a reason. The reason is for Allah to keep you to the time that He wants you to serve Him. He will now ask you, why I did not kill you and I give you all what you need and you did not serve me? So today's khutbah will not based on La taqnatu an rahmatillah. Do not lose hope. Since you are still alive, don't lose hope. These are the people Allah reach. But me, my own is just Talakawa. Who told you? Allah changes things within a second. All of us Nigerians, we have lost hope on Obasanjo as back as 2008. That they have already written him off. Abacha has already passed the judge. Killing. He was among of the people they want to kill. Before a year to that time, his name was announced as president of the country. Who is doing it? It's him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who says you will not become where you are looking at? But the only thing is, slow down. Just slow down with Allah. He knows where He's taking you and myself to. But the problem is, we are too eager. And brother, don't spoil your name before that place will come to you. La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't ever lose hope. Don't lose hope. I can never get out. Who told you? For this kind of the sins I have committed, wallahi, I will not enter paradise. I know I just go to the hell. Who told you? That's why the judgment of another person does not lie on your hand. That person, now the hell in they go. Who told you? Who says you that you are praying day and night, we enter paradise? Stop judging another person. And you too, don't lose hope in yourself. Don't look down that I will not. No. Everything, just put it to the hands of Allah. I'll be praying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Qul ya ibadi." This ayah come when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came as a prophet and told the Sahaba and told some Medina, told some people in Mecca, come to Allah, Allah will forgive you. Some of them say, if not through God will forgive you for the kind of the sins we have committed, God will not have mercy on us. Allah said, "Qul, tell them Muhammad, ya ibadi, my servant, alladhina asrau ala anfusim, that they have right off their mind, saying, God will not forgive me." Allah said, "La taqunatu an rahmat, la taqunatu min rahmatillah." Do not lose hope from Allah's mercy. Brother, this ayah come to you and myself today. We shouldn't lose hope at all. We shouldn't lose hope. Allah will not have blessing on me. Hey, I've married. This is 20 years now, no child. I can never get child again. Who told you? Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. How many years did this stay? Interceded. Some say 90 years. Some say 100 plus before Allah answered him. Zachariah stayed for long years. Pray for one thing. Oh Allah, give me child. Oh Allah, give me child. And Allah answered. Ayub stayed long on a sickness that people are saying, no, this one will die soon. And he wake up. So brother, do stop losing hope. Stop losing hope. It's because we are losing hope in Allah. That's why we are committing ourselves into some certain sins. We are doing Yahoo Plus because we are looking for the fast money. We are committing in a ritual. We are looking for the fast money. We are engaging in the corruption. Money that's supposed to go to the many people, only you are packing it because I don't want my children to be poor. Who Allah has already written. The one that will do mechanic is there already. No matter how rich you are, your money cannot make your children become a rich. And be a security mechanic or laborer in a site does not mean your child will not become billionaire. It's him, Allah. I don't want my family to suffer. You are not carrying what you're not supposed to carry. You are doing yourself. You do yourself, they will carry you to the prison. Look at this guy, Osh Poppy, 20 years in prison now because he wants to become a fast millionaire or billionaire. Where is he now? They passed the judgment, 20 years in prison. So what he was looking for to get, where did he end up to? And you see somebody without any power, without anything, and he becomes something. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one of his hadith reported by Abi Dharr radiyallahu anhu qala an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam anillahi tabaarak wa ta'ala annahu qala ya ibadi. Hadith was reported by Abi Dharr radiyallahu anhu. He said, I heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had it straight from Allah, hadith al-qudsi from Allah, direct speech from Allah, that Allah say, ya ibadi, my servants, innakum takhti'una bil-layli wal-nahar, you have been committing a sin in the night and the day, wa anna aghfur dhunuba, and it is me, Allah, I forgive the sin. Don't just look down. Hey, I used to drink alcohol. Hey, I used to smoke wee-wee. Hey, I used to take cigarette. Hey, my own is zina. My own is eating haram. Does not mean Allah will not forgive you. If you are ready to stop, the condition of tawbah is three. The condition of repentance to Allah is just three. If you just follow it, no more things. You can even swear that I never do it in my life. Number one is to have the intention of stop, number one. An-nadamu ala ma fata, that is number one. An-nadamu ala ma fata. Firstly, regret on that action. See what you are doing wrong as a bad thing. Allah will say, okay, you are ready to. But by the time you see that, people are doing this anyway, not only me. If you say astaghfirullah, Allah will not listen to you. Say astaghfirullah, but not be only me, they do them now. The first thing on the tower is another more. Allah my father. regrets. Firstly, regret on that action. Among all these Muslim brothers sitting in the mosque, na me they drink alcohol. Among these brothers sitting here, na me they smoke. Na me they do zina. That's regretful. That regretfulness, we go to Almighty Allah. Say, okay, this one is ready to come to me. That is number one. Number two, and you have in your mind that we never go there. وَأَلَّا يَعُدَّ إِلَيْهِ فِي أُمْرِهِ فِي مَا بَكْيَ مِنْ أُمْرِهِ is to have in your mind, I will never go back to that sin. That is number two. And number three, you now pronounce, oh Allah, forgive me. This, after this one, you don't need to, hey, somebody called me a woman called. She said, assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam ajiya. She said, please, there is a sin I was committing before, and now I want to stop. And I called one of my malam in Kano. He said, as you go and buy rago, black and white separate, as you slaughter them. So the question is, I want to ask from you, is it the night as you do it or in the afternoon? I smile. I said, what that rago is for what? And because I want to stop the sin I was doing before. I said, hey, madam, can you send the money for that rago? Just send the money to us. There is nothing like that. Allah doesn't drink blood. Some of you that will come around, come and do dua for me. We should slaughter. Me, myself, I do tell people. It's not compulsory. Where did you see it? If you want to do saraka, do saraka. But because you pray for me, as you slaughter, where did you see it? Ma qala hadha Allahu wa ma fa'alahu Rasul. Allah has never said it. Prophet has never done it. But because of malam, we want to eat rago. You now say, okay, malam, you go and buy the big rago. Where did you see it? Malam, those of you are lying for the people. Nowhere to be found in the Quran. From Surah Al-Fatiha to Surah Al-Nas, nowhere to be found in the Quran. Say, when you finish prayer or your slaughter, only Udhiyya, Ilayya, Salah, Allah say, Fasalli li Rabbika wanhar. Go and pray Eid and slaughter. But any other place, because you want to do your slaughter for where? I want to repent from my sin. I should go and slaughter for what? That blood for what? Is it for Allah to say, okay, Allah, this is bribery, I bribe you, make you drink this one for your blood, Where do you see that one? Nothing, brother. To repent does not take you anything. Just go back to him. Anibu ila rabbikum wa aslimu lahu. Allah said, anibu. Just turn to him. Turn to me. Anibu ila rabbikum. Just come. Turn to me. Wa aslimu lahu. And you submit yourself to me. Anibu ila rabbikum waslimu lahu. Naam Sheikh, anibu ila rabbikum waslimu lahu. Min qabli an yatikum la adhab thumma la tunsaru. Allah say, turn to me. Please, as if you are just begging. Please turn back to me. Waslimu lahu. And you submit yourself to me. Min qabli an yatikum la adhab thumma la tunsaru. Before my punishment will come. And you will never ask, you will never see any helper to help you. وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا رَبِّكُمْ. Allah says, وَاتَّبِعُوا, after you have repented to Almighty Allah, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ. Allah said, then, after you have repented, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ. Then, try to be doing the good thing. After you have repented, I'm not smoking again, inshallah. I'm not drinking alcohol again, inshallah. I'm not doing zina again, inshallah. I'm not eating haram again, inshallah. After you have repented, Allah said, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ. Then, be doing the good thing. Be doing the good thing. مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ. From what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to you to be doing. Min qabli an yatiyakum al-adhab baghtatan wa antum la tash'urun. Before the punishment of Allah will come, direct, suddenly, the death comes suddenly, brother. This brother we just announced his death. The day he fell down to the day he died, he could not utter a word till he died. When I heard, I was so shocked that if I were the one, I was expecting to say, astaghfirullah, when I want to die. And this brother died 3 days, he fell down, he died without uttering a, they were just calling him, just, till he died. No tongue to say astaghfirullah. If you are the one, brother, uncle, and you are still postponing. And when I'm still just 27 years, when I'm 30 years, I will stop. Eh? Who told you that you reach 29 or 28? Just the best thing, Allah said, the best servant of me is those who hear about me and they drop what they are doing immediately. Brother, as we are sitting down, let us seek Allah's forgiveness in our mind for what we are doing wrong. May Almighty Allah forgive all our shortcomings and we should not return back there. In a hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue in that hadith. Fastaghfiruni. Find me. Fastaghfiruni. Seek forgiveness from me, Allah. Akfiru lakum. I will forgive you. Allah say, ya ibadi, law anna awwalakum. Allah say, hey, my servant, if the first creation among of you, wa akhirakum, and the last creation, wa insakum, and the female among of you, wa jinnakum, and the jinn, you gather yourselves, human being, and the jinn, you gather yourself. Kanu ala taqa qalbi rajulin wahid. If all of you say, okay, now as from today, we are not committing sin again. We want to become one, as a one person, to be serving you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah say, ma zada dhalika fi mulki shay'an. That one does not increase anything in my dominion. Nothing is increased. See, all of us in this mosque, we are not committing sin again, no. Wallahi, doesn't increase anything in Allah's mercy. Allah continue, ya ibadi, oh my servant, law anna awwalakum, if the first of you wa akhirakum, and the last of you wa insakum, and the women and the men wa jinnakum, and the jinn and the human being, kanu ala abjuri qalbi rajulin wahid, if all of you gather yourselves to become a thug, to become a bad person, we are not serving him again. All of you, if you gather, ma naqasa dhalika min mulki shay'an, it does not decrease anything in my mercy. It doesn't decrease anything. And it's because of prayer we are praying. That's why God is still existing. Who told you? He has been in existence before the creation of the heart and the heaven. So if you now say, I'm not doing it again, who are you? All of us that we are here now, we are nothing in the global of Nigeria. All of us living in Lugbe, we are not serving God again. They will not even hear our voice in Asokoro. Talk of Nasarawa, talk of Maiduguri, talk of Enugu. Who will know that you are a sister? So our sister itself, Allah is just using it as a mulik. If you say, I will not go to mosque again. Are you fighting God or you are fighting human being? The way they are talking in the mosque, me, I will not go to that mosque again. I will just look at you and say, now only you. Now you make the mosque existing. Or if you don't pray again, the people will not pray again. You are doing yourself. You are doing yourself. Say, wallahi, me, I'm not going to go to mosque again, no, because the way the mom, so you are praying for the mom. You stop that. We are seeing, we are hearing in this our locality here. Say, somebody jump from one mosque to another, jump from one mosque to another. Are you praying for a woman being, brother? You stop that rubbish. It's a rubbish. I don't pray with these people again. I pray with these people. What is, you're not turning the prayer to politics. Or what can we call it? We should just stop that. We should stop that. Serve God alone, direct. Serve God without attaching anything. That's all I'm telling you. Kul ya ibadi, who are my servants? Alladhina asrawu ala anfusihim. Those of you that we have even lose hope. Allah says, la taqnatu. Do not lose hope. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Oh, you believe. Let me tell you something. Ma yakunu min najwa min thalatha. If three of you are whispering something, or you are gisting, illa huwa rabi'u, it's me, Allah, number four. Wala khamsa, if you are five in number, you are gisting, illa huwa sadisuhu, I am number six. Wala adena, if you are the only one, you lock the door, nobody sees me. You draw the curtain. Allah say, I'm beside you, I am number two. Wala akthar, if you are many, say, today, we must remove social person from a social post. Hey, you are many. Allah say, I'm the last number. Say, how many of us? We are 1 million. Allah say, you that 1,000,000.1. That one is me. So, brother, what do you think you are doing that Allah doesn't see you? There's nothing you can do that Allah doesn't see you. That's why Allah say, whatever you are doing, innama a'malukum, all your deeds will see him. I am keeping it for you. Thumma uwafiikum iyaha. I will give everybody the equal reward of what you have done. Faman wajada khayran. But when you see the good thing, when you see the good, fali yahmidillah. Thank Allah. Waman wajada ghayra dhalik. But if you see something else, fala yulmanna illa nafsa. Do not blame anybody, blame yourself. That's the meaning of fa'amma man utiya kitabahu bi yaminihi fayaqulu ya hum fayaqulu ha hum qura'u kitabiya inni dhanantu anni mulakin hisabiha fa huwa fi 'ayshatin radiya fi jannatin 'aliya qutufu wa janiya kulu washrabu ani am bima aslaftum fi yamin fil ayamin khaliya wa amma man utiya kitabahu bi shimali fayaqulu ya laitani lam uta kitabiya wa lam adri ma hisabiya. Allah say anybody that sees his record, the grammatical meaning is fa amma man utiya kitaba bi yamin, anybody that collect the book with right hand, who is going to give? Have you ever asked ourselves? Allah has never mentioned the Quran saying, on the day of judgment, I will give you book. Or Jibreel will be the one to give. Allah has explained that ayah. That ayah, for amma man utiya. Allah explained it in Surah Al-Isra'il. Allah has explained Surah Al-Isra'il. Wa kullu insani alzamnahu ta'irahu fi unukihi. Everybody's slate record has been hung on his neck. Wa yawm al-qiyamati wa nukhrijahu yawm al-qiyamati kitaban. Allah said, on the day of judgment, you will see that book will not come, that your slate will not come out, kitaban, as a book. You see it like this. Mansura, clean, plain, clean book. They will not be telling everybody, ikra kitabak. Everybody read your book. Wakafa binafsika liyawmin alayka hasiba. You are a good accountant of yourself. Calculate it. You now calculate, hey, salat 20. Hey, fasting 10. Hey, sadaqah, hey, 2. That's how you, Allah said, you calculate by yourself. And before that one, announcement will come first. Go and read the hadith. Announcement will come first. What announcement? That Prophet ﷺ said on the day of judgment, they will raise all of us on our big toes. Everybody will stand on his big toes. On the day of judgment, we stand on our big toes, Aryan, naked. And they will bring down the sun. The distance between the sun and the head of the man will just be the distance between the armlets, the distance of the arm. Everybody will be sweating according to his sins. He mentioned the hadith. Some people's sins, sweat will be on their ankle, some will be on their nail, some will be in the middle of their body. It will be bubbling the way they used to cook soup. Chop, chop, bubbling. They said that one will be two, it will serve for the two punishments. Number one, for the people who enter the paradise, it will clean all the sins, small, small sins, the lie we used to lie. May Allah forgive us. It will clean small, small sins. But for the people of the hell, it's the additional punishment before they enter the hell. But thou, Prophet mentioned seven people. May Allah count us among these seven people, that they will not even express this. But this standing, we express standing. We may not express the sun. It's just, he said, some people will be under the shade of Allah. He did not say they will not stand. Everybody will still be understanding. The announcement that will firstly come is, they will make announcements. If you score 100, Jannah to Firdaus. 90, Jannah to this. 80, Jannah to this. 70, Jannah to this. 60, Jannah to this. But from 50, for instance, is an example. 50, this hellfire. 45, this hellfire. No, 50. 50 is midu, Abi. That is Ashabul Araf. La min awla wa la min awla. They will not be in the hell, they will not be in the paradise. They will be in the midu. The breeze of paradise will come and say, hey, what an enjoyment. The heat of the hell will come, hey, my head, oh. That's how they will live. They will continue living. That's how they will continue living. Ashabul Araf. Allah mentioned Surah Al-Araf is in the Quran. We have everything, but we don't read. But from 49, this hellfire. 42, 1, this hellfire. They will now say, everybody, Ikura Kitabak, read your book. And I look at my own. Hey, 32. Say, ah. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The day of Qiyamah is not funny. And Allah is giving us example every day. Our children, they are writing exams, writing waek, writing jam. All this is an example. You score 160 and say, I want to go and read medicine. Which university in this Nigeria? Saying, I want to become a doctor. Your jam give you 120. That's how the process is. You are praying. Allah, 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 Allah. Brother, what are you praying? Jannah too. That prayer will give you Jannah. There's a visabilillah. See the basket, visabilillah. You look, which one is nylon or 15 naira or 20 naira. And you are pushing 1,000 and say, man, paradise. Which paradise? No, you are judging yourself now, brothers. It's because of time. We are judging ourselves from this world. We want to build mosque. You have means to donate one block. But instead of it, today that one block, you have girlfriend on social media that you are transferring money to. You now say paradise. Are you deceiving God? May Allah guide us aright. So after this one, everybody check his book. Iqra Kitabak. After that one, hey, I've already seen my home. Allah say, Wajia yawma idhin bi jahannam. Wajia yawma idhin bi jahannam. They will not bring the jahannam. Hey, this is the hello. Is that hell that will pursue all of us? The top will remove. That jahannam they will bring. Another announcement will come before that. What is that announcement is? Your property that belongs to another person, you have time now to go and collect it. Go and look for more reward. That's why I say, فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ السَّاخَةَ يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِهِ وَهُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ مُرْءٍ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. But then they bring that L. So, okay, now you can go and remove, you can go and look for more reward. I'm in 32 and I'm looking for 51. You are not carrying my pen. I will not come and collect it. That's right, brother. Those of you are sitting on another person's sweat. Hey, oh, you are keeping it for the person. You are keeping it. You are eating around. You are saying nothing will happen. That's what they do for this country. We are talking about the increase. What they call it? Interest. So now 0.5 interest. They have been telling us that time has gone. Brother, we should just fear that day. We should fear that day. You are not thinking that I just encroach small plots of land. Encroach, continue. You are keeping it for the person now. They will not release that hell. When they release the hell, so everybody will be looking. That's what I say. Fa'ida ja ati sakha. When that fitna, that is sakha too. Sakha means the fitna of looking for more reward. Whenever he's looking for marijuana, Yama Yafiru Limaru mean Akihi, the day two brothers will be running away from themselves. Hey! Now me kill my brother. Oh, and you see the brother coming. That day, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, every eye contact will see themselves that day. Me and you don't see like this. Either I do you good or bad, we see ourselves on the day of judgment. That's why. Think, how are you relating with people? The person you meet for one time and you make him cry for his right. That day you see him. Wa ummihi wa abihi. The children and the parents will be running away from themselves. Ummihi wa abihi. Father will be running away from the child. Hey! Now that's one stupid boy is he come. Make him not see me. The mother will be running, dodging. Wa sahibatihi wa bani. Sahiba, husband and wife. Those of you just wake up. I'm getting the masalasi. Your wife is sleeping. You don't pour water on her. Go and pray. Daddy, she will come. Say, oh Allah, you should not go to paradise. He never asked me to pray. But if I don't cook soup, better soup, he will fight me. That day is coming. Why are we not deceiving ourselves? In the name of we know waiting. Allah said, I did not send any messenger than to just say and keep quiet. That's why we are saying this one. Because Allah said, وَلَنَسْ أَلَّنَّ الَّذِينَ وُرِسْلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْ أَلَّنَّ الْمُرِسَلِينَ. And we ask those of you know and you keep quiet. And we ask those of you heard and you did not do anything. Brother, fastaghfirullaha rabbakum innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.